We are going to study about the protocordates. You know the phylum Chordata can be divided into two subphylum. First one is the Urochordata and second one is the Cephalochordata. The Urochordata and Cephalochordata are collectively called as the protocordates. First, we studied about the Urochordata, then now we are going to study about the subphylum Cephalochordata. The word Cephalochordata is derived from a Greek word that is cephalos means head and chordata means notochord. That means notochord present throughout the life, that is from head to the tail region. Now we study about the general characters of the subphylum Cephalochordata. The animals which include in this subphylum all are free swimming animals. Body is metamerically segmented. Notochord is present and extends in head region, that means from tail up to the head region. The nerve cord is dorsal to the body. There is no distinct brain and brain box. Midgut diverticulum acts as a liver. That means it is enlarged and extends into the body. Many pairs of protonephridia are present. That is, the protonephridia are related to the excretory system. Then sexes are separate. Fertilization is external, that means the fertilization takes place outside the body. Then metamorphosis observed during the development. Now this Cephalochordata can be classified into leptochordi, that means there is only one class. Now we will see the general characters of the class Leptochordi. That is, they include small marine fish-like animals. Mostly, they remain buried in the sand. Notochord is permanent and extends from tip of snout to the tail. That means from head up to the tail region. Then presence of dorsal tubular hollow nerve cord not distinguished into brain and spinal cord is degenerate type. Pharynx is large with many gill slits. That is, the pharynx is perforated by the gill slits. Endostyle and atrium are well developed. Nephridia are the organs of the excretion. Then mode of feeding is ciliary. Sexes are separate. Then gonads are without gonoducts. Fertilization is external. Then myotomes are present, which are helpful for the locomotion of the animal. There are no paired fins and body is laterally complex. For example, the amphioxus. You see the animal amphioxus, that is, the body is differentiated two ends. One is the cephalic, and second one is the caudal or the tail region. At the dorsal side, there is presence of the notochord and also the neurochord. At the cephalic region, there is presence of the oral hood, which is encircled by the cilia, that is for the ciliary mode of feeding. You see, there are pharyngeal gill clefts and the body is laterally compressed. We studied about the topic protocordates. Now we'll see about the exercise, that is which type of questions will be asked. There are three types. First one is the multiple choice questions. Second one is the short answer type questions. And third one is the long answer type questions. First, we see about the multiple choice questions. First, which one amongst the following is not a basic character of a chordate? Option first, dorsal tubular nervous system. Second, dorsal solid nervous system. Third, pharyngeal gill slits. And fourth one is the presence of a notochord. That is, the answer is B1, that is dorsal solid nervous system. Now second, protochordates include, that is first one is urochordata and cephalochordata, second cephalochordata and birds, third urochordata and pisces, and fourth one is the urochordata and snakes. That is, the correct answer is urochordata and cephalochordata. Now third, what is the feeding habit of urochordates? First, mostly predators. Second, mostly scavengers. Third, autotrophic. Fourth, mostly ciliary filter feeders. That is, the correct answer is D, mostly ciliary filter feeders. Fourth one is, for ciliary filter feeding, which part of the alimentary canal is highly developed, large and sac-like? A. Pharynx. B. Mouth. C. Intestine. D. Liver. The correct answer is liver. And fifth, retrogressive metamorphosis is seen in A. Pisces. B. Amphibia. C. Cephalochordata. And D. Urochordata. The correct answer is urochordata. Sixth, the Greek word aura means A. Auricle. B. Atrium. C. Tail. Then D. Head. The correct answer C, that is tail. Which organism amongst the following is not a urochordate? A. Amphioxus. B. Pyrosoma. C. Hornmania. D. Doliolum. The correct answer is A. Amphioxus. Amphioxus obtains food by A. Predation. B. Scavenging. C. Biting and chewing. Then D. Ciliary filter feeding. The correct answer is D. Ciliary filter feeding. Then, in which one of the following organisms the notochord extends from anterior end to posterior end? A. Hornmania. B. Salpa. C. Amphioxus. And D. Pyrosoma. The correct answer is amphioxus. Then last, in which one of the following adult animals tail is present? A. Hermania, B. Acidia, C. Amphioxus, and D. Salpa. The correct answer is C. Amphioxus. Then the short answer type questions. First, give general characters of subphylum Urochordata. Give general characters of subphylum Cephalochordata. Third, give general characters of class Ascidiaceae. Then, give general characters of class Thaliacea. Give general characters of class Larvacea. Then, write a note on general characters of class Leptocardi. Then, the long answer type questions. First, give the general characters of the class Urochordata and classify it up to subclasses giving examples. Then second, give general characters of the class Cephalochordata and classify it up to subclass giving example. Then classify giving regions Salpa, Icoplura, Hodmania, and Ascidia.